knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
In the previous tutorial, we discussed early therapy, and specifically psychoanalysis. Freud and other early figures in the field relied on psychoanalysis and free association to reveal the repressed thoughts and wishes of mentally ill patients. They believed that by understanding and working through these repressed unconscious thoughts, a person could be cured. So, what do therapists actually do today? In some ways, therapy today is similar to what Freud would do. The core of a therapy session is really just the client talking to their therapist about whatever they wish. Often, a therapy session will be treated like a problem-solving session. The therapist will likely start by asking things like how the client is doing, what's been bothering them, or if there's anything they want to talk about. The client can then talk openly and share their thoughts and feelings. There is no judgment or criticism. The client gets to say exactly how they feel under strict confidentiality. And clients aren't required to talk about certain things either. What is talked about in therapy depends on the goals of the client. If their goals aren't dependent on the past, the client is unlikely to have to talk about their childhood or their parents or any other such thing. Different therapists are also trained in different techniques, and they may use these in addition to talk therapy during a session. Art therapy, for example, may be added to the talking part of the therapy session. Some therapists may suggest adding meditation, while others assign homework to be completed between sessions. Still, other therapists may help the client rehearse challenging conversations through role-playing exercises. No matter what is added, the critical aspect of modern therapy is that the client works together with the therapist to improve themselves over time. A key difference between Freud's psychoanalysis and modern therapy is the actual role of the therapist. For example, you may have noticed that instead of saying patients, we are using the term clients. This is how most therapists refer to the people they work with today, and this is largely the result of what is known as person or client-centered therapy. In the middle of the 20th century, psychologist Carl Rogers proposed that therapy could be simpler and warmer by focusing on the client. Instead of having a doctor interpret the client's unconscious motives, Rogers believed that therapists should let the client run the therapy session. The client is responsible for improving their own life, and it is the client that tells the therapist what they believe is wrong. The therapist listens and encourages their client as they work through various issues. They don't make decisions for their client. Instead, they act as a sounding board. By being warm and understanding, a therapist can help their client accept themselves and lead a happy and fulfilling life. In a client-centered approach, it's the relationship between the therapist and the client that drives change. A client-centered approach is fundamental to most modern therapy, but it's rarely used by itself. It's often instead combined with other forms of therapy, one of the most commonly used being cognitive behavioral therapy, or CBT. The goal of CBT is to identify destructive or disturbing thoughts and replace them with more realistic and objective ones. Disturbing thoughts can have a direct impact on a person's feelings and behavior. In identifying these upsetting and unrealistic thoughts, people can improve their mood and lead a happier life. CBT is very effective, and clients can see improvements within a relatively short time period. Also, CBT focuses on developing skills. This allows clients to better help themselves in the future. CBT is effective in a variety of situations, including depression, anxiety, phobias, eating disorders, and addiction. These therapy models lie on the assumption that a client wants to get better. The core idea is that through the therapist's tools and support, the client will be able to think about their problems differently. Once they have these tools, they will likely be able to deal with any similar problems they may have in the future. Sometimes, however, people need additional measures to get better. This is where medication may come in. To be clear, medication does not mean that someone has failed at therapy. Instead, medication can be a very helpful part of managing a mental illness. This is because medication can reduce the symptoms associated with a mental illness, making it easier for a person to learn the skills necessary to cope with their symptoms. Antidepressants could help alleviate severe depression, and anti-anxiety medication could lessen intense worries. Medication doesn't solve everything, and different people respond in different ways, but when negative symptoms aren't overwhelming everything else, it's a lot easier for people to succeed at therapy. In fact, there is evidence that medication, in addition to therapy, is more effective than just medication or therapy alone. Now, you may have heard therapists called different things. Some may be psychologists, some are psychiatrists, and some are social workers. What's the difference? All of these people can offer psychotherapy, but there are some differences in their training. Psychologists have a doctoral degree and may have a PhD, or Doctor of Philosophy, a PsyD, or Doctor of Psychology, or an EdD, or Doctor of Education. Psychologists learn about all aspects of human behavior, but have a specific emphasis on research and scientific methods, while some are more focused on clinical work than research. Psychiatrists actually go to medical school and have an MD or DO. Psychiatrists focus on the biology behind mental illness. They are also allowed to prescribe medication, unlike most psychologists or social workers. Social workers actually have a degree in social work. They could have an MSW, or Master of Social Work, or LCSW, which means Licensed Clinical Social Worker. They could have an MFT, or Master of Marriage and Family Therapy, or LMFT, which means Licensed Marriage and Family Therapist. With each of these types of therapist, one typically has a certain specialization. Some may focus on children, others on older adults. Some may also specialize in specific issues like eating disorders or drug abuse. So what about life coaches? While people may go to them to improve their lives, life coaches are not therapists, and they may or may not have any training in any field that is relevant to their profession. Both therapists and life coaches can be helpful depending on the circumstances, but they should not be confused with one another. One of the most important differences is that therapists are qualified to treat mental illnesses, while life coaches are not. A trained therapist will be able to help you through mental health problems like depression and anxiety. Another difference is their orientation. Life coaches are generally focused on the future. They want to help you achieve your future goals. Therapists tend to be more focused on your past and present and helping you heal. Still, it is possible that a life coach could be able to help you understand how your past impacts your future, and a therapist can also help you achieve your future goals. So, with all of that information, how do you know the best person to go to for your mental health? Unfortunately, there's no easy way to know, and you may in fact go to a combination of different people. For instance, you may see a psychiatrist and a social worker, but the psychiatrist will only be in charge of your medication. Therapy is also a very personal thing. Different therapists have different styles, and not every style works for every person. If you decide to go to therapy, don't be afraid to try a different therapist if you aren't comfortable with the one you currently have. Therapy can be extremely effective in treating mental illness, but the right fit between therapist and client is critical. At the end of the day, modern therapy is a collaboration between a client and their mental health team. The therapist is really there to help their client. By working together, the client and therapist can minimize the possibility of negative mental health symptoms cropping up in the future. Psychology and therapy have progressed a lot since Freud, but in some ways, it's the same. Through talking and exploring their feelings, people can better understand themselves and lead more fulfilling lives.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.